space. Again, thank you for clicking on this video and welcome back to my channel. Y'all, like I said last night with my Croatia reaction, by the way, check that out if you haven't. I am going to try and start getting back on my reaction request list in addition to continuing with our series. And so we're doing another one tonight. Surprise, surprise. We are doing another request that I got quite a while ago. So I'm sorry if you're still on the channel and you requested this, I'm sorry it's taken so long. And if you're not on the channel anymore, then I guess it doesn't matter. But anyway, I'm doing it anyway because I want to watch this. So I am reacting to a Dutch performance from the past. I can't remember. This might be my first Dutch performance that I've reacted to from the past, from before like 2006 when we started our series. And so I reacted to 2007, I want to say, which was Etsilia. Etsilia performed at Eurovision 2007 for the Netherlands with the song On Top of the World. And I really liked her voice. I liked her unique vibrato and her unique timbre. And so some of y'all told me that I should react to her 1998 performance for the Netherlands. I didn't know she had performed multiple times, so that's really cool. So I am so excited to be reacting to her performance from Eurovision 1998. I'm so sorry. It's called Hemel en Aarde. And as I understand it, I think I looked it up once. That means heaven and earth. Does it or does it not? Let me know. Anyway, super excited to get into this and see what Etsilia brought the first time she was at Eurovision.
Misschien de dromen werkelijkheid worden. Jullie gaan natuurlijk dik makker.
I love that they introduce the conductors. I'm like, go you. Where those live instruments really wake a body up. Oh, are we gonna have groove? Is this groovy? His hair. Listen to that voice. That's that voice I love. Ooh, I love the dance moves for the backing singers. That is so cool to see them actually playing live. Get low, girl. I like that. They said, you better belt that. She said, Antillia. I see you, girl. Yeah, I still love her voice line. That's not going to change. But I do think it's interesting that this is so different than On Top of the World. Just because, like, On Top of the World was much more poppy. It was much more, I was going to say much more upbeat. And it kind of was in a way. But then also this was pretty upbeat. But this was upbeat in like a slightly darker, funkier, groovier way. So it's just interesting to feel the differences between those two songs, because they were like night and day. This was really good. I liked this. I don't think I could pick one over the other. I actually like them both. Maybe if I thought about it for a little longer, I could pick one over the other, but I really like this. But let me know which you prefer. Do you prefer this or do you prefer On Top of the World? I liked the groove, and I liked how, along with the groovy songs, you get the groovy dance moves, and it's just kind of a whole groovy performance. You could tell she was really into it, and I love that the backing vocalists were equally into it, so like that you could tell they were on the same accord with everything. Her voice was great as always. It's so unique sounding. I don't know, something about it just really tickles my ear. And I love the live orchestra. I love the live orchestra because that just, it just feels more invigorated, honestly. Like you could just, when you can hear the strings live and you can hear the drums live, it just feels a lot more, well, lifelike. So anyway, let me know what you think about this. I'd love to hear. Please like this video. I would love it if you did. It always helps me out. And please consider subscribing if you have not. But anyway, thank you for clicking on this video. Thank you for watching this video. And as always, I'll see you next time.